Evening, everyone. The questions left for the Reds to answer. How good are their young players? How much pride do they have left to play for? And how much aggravation can they cause the contenders? First up, the East-leading Atlanta Braves. Elmer Descends outpitched Glavine last week and lost. Finding the short end immediately tonight in Atlanta, Brian Jordan with a first-inning single, scores Giles 1-0. They were down 2-0 when Bob Boone complained about Javi Lopez leaving the catcher's box, so they had to paint the lines again. Still Reds down 3-0 in the eighth. Junior finds the chalk on the right line into the corner. Don't have to paint that again. Adam Dunn all the way from first, 3-1. Then it's Casey through the box, through the hole. Junior scores. It's 3-2. Mm-hmm. Bases loaded. Todd Walker off the bench delivers. Base hit to right center. Boone and Young give the Reds a 4-3 lead. Cromer adds a sac fly, 5-3, but bottom of eight, Danny Graves with a balk and a wild pitch. Chipper Jones in to make it 5-4, bottom of nine. First and third, two outs. B.J. Surhoff bounces to Walker, who underhands, and how about this? The Reds pull one off in Atlanta, 5-4.
I think they got to play first place teams. I think that's the key. Forget about all those guys in third and fourth place.
Yeah,
play
rise,
first place team.
Rise to the level.
Right, that's right. Cream rises to the top, doesn't
that's
it?
Right.
They got to be more than a little confused in Atlanta the way the Reds have played this season. The Braves had to think this would be easy money this week. But you know what? The joke's on the Braves. Let's start with Adam Dunn. Another two-hit night, and this one came early. It's a little flare out to left field. Dunn has enough pop on this and enough speed on the bases to turn it into a double. Two for six tonight. He's now hitting .364. He scores on a Sean Casey double. It was 2-0 when Dimitri Young steps up, and bang! Yeah, let's trade this guy. Two-run shot, right field is 10th. In the first inning, the Reds had all the runs they would need. Bottom one, Braves load him up. I think Dunn can play this year game. Fly ball right field, he'll track it down. And he comes up throwing. Watch the play at the plate. Mark DeRosa testing Dunn's arm, and Dunn passes the test. He's out. Missed the plate. More defense. Here's a stat. LaRue leads the majors. He's thrown out 61% of the guys who've tried to steal on him. Andrew Jones apparently didn't get the message. Jim Brouwer pitched well tonight, got his fifth win of the season. His only strikeout, but he went six strong. And just up from the minors, Scott McRae got in the game and tossed two innings of no-hit baseball. Two hits tonight for Dunn, for Junior, for Casey, and for Jason LaRue, who comes to the plate in the fifth and ices this one. 11-3 is the final. That is two straight for the Reds. Down.
I can fool anybody here in the minor league, which is easy. Can I ever do in the major league? Remain to be seen.
Jose Rijo's minor league stats are outstanding. His stuff is a different story. Reds pitching coach Don Gullett watched Rijo's last outing and said afterward that Jose would have been killed if he was pitching in the big leagues. Tonight, Rijo threw two innings in relief for Louisville, giving up one run while striking out two. So in five minor league outings, he's pitched 15 innings and has a 2.40 ERA. Louisville won tonight's game 8-4 with Dennis Reyes getting the win. While Rijo faced the Richmond Braves tonight, the Reds were looking to sweep a three-game series from the Atlanta Braves this afternoon. Bright sunshine when Adam Dunn stepped up in the third, and something tells me Braves shortstop Mark DeRosa will be looking for a new pair of Oakleys. Now that is embarrassing. Todd Walker scored. Dunn's hitting .346 in his first six games. Dunn and Walker had a less enjoyable tag team effort one inning later. Now, I know they've only been teammates a few days, but I've got it is fairly standard lingo. Luckily, both players were okay. The same can't be said for rookie pitcher Jose Acevedo. He had a 2-1 lead in the fourth when he gave up a triple to Paul Bacco. He of the 192 batting average. Andrew Jones and Mark DeRosa scored, putting the Braves up 3-2. Not only did Bacco have a 192 average, he entered the game with four RBI, a figure he doubled today when he added a two-run double in the sixth. No sweep for you. The Braves win the finale 11-3. And this just in, Pokey Reese loathes Jim Bowden. On his radio show yesterday, Bowden said Pokey would like to be traded and is unhappy, adding that he's a great player having an underachieving year. Well, Pokey responded as follows to Hal McCoy of the Dayton Daily News. If he thinks I'm not performing because I want to be traded, well, let him come down here and put the uniform on. If he feels that way, I hope he trades me and trades me soon. Now, I really want out of here. Reese, who is making $3.2 million this year.
Lead on the Philadelphia Phillies, Reds and Braves.
Kevin Millwood, hasn't won since April, been on the DL for a long time. Here, Adam Dunn, the rookie who's just come up for the Reds. High pop, Mark DeRosa, look out. Too high, as it turns out. Oh, two runs will score. Painful. 2-0 Reds on the error. E6. We'd hear more from him, though. Chipper Jones, 4-for-5, strokes this. And away we go. 29th of the year. Braves trail 2-1. Paul Bacco, 2 on and 2 out. Rips this into right center field. 1 Brave will score. 2 Braves will score. Braves take a 3-2 lead, and Bacco 2-for-4 with 4 RBIs. Now back to DeRosa. You know he wants to do a little better than that.
Yeah, I'm trying to atone for the pop-up loss in the Sun. Solid sinker to center. Brian Jordan coming in to score. Braves up 4-2, and DeRosa continues to impress, filling in for Fracal. And then Paul Bacco getting to start because Javi Lopez has a bad back. He's usually the personal catcher for Maddox, and that's it. But he has a big day. And then DeRosa, a base hit to right field. The 7 and 8 hitters, DeRosa and Bacco, 5 hits, 6 RBIs, and it's all Braves today.
Braves take this, the final 11-3. Again, Chipper Jones, the 4-for-5 day. DeRosa, 3-for-4 with 2 RBIs. Rookie Adam Dunn, by the way, 1-for-4 with an RBI for the Reds. You saw him there. He's looked great in his first week up in the bigs. Kevin Millwood would go 6.